Thanks for staying with us. On to the sports news now. Here's the big blow to Team India. Zahir Khan's injury was cited as the number one reason for India losing the Lord's Test. And now India's pace spearhead has been ruled out of the second test at Trent Bridge that begins tomorrow. Zahir picked up a hamstring injury on day one of the first test and was seen being put through a lot of drills to try get him back into shape. However, Dhoni had hinted that they will not be risking Zach if he's not 100%.
You know, it's a bit disappointing to not to have him, you know, for selection in the first 11. But it's something, you know, that's beyond our control, that we always say, you know, injuries, it keeps on happening on and off. So overall, you know, it's a win-win situation for the Indian team, because we can't really sit and say, okay, Zahir is not there. But we have to look at the positive, which is, you know, some of the other bowlers will get to have a look at international cricket.
Well, just under about 48 hours to go before that second test, and the visitors are not just 1-0 down in the series, but are in dire straits as far as trying to field a full-strength side is concerned. For the English, it's just a question of keeping their foot on the pedal as they inch towards the number one test tag.
Hurt, beaten, weakened. There's no doubt Dhoni and company have their backs to the wall. But Trent Bridge is a venue the team will have happy memories of, having won that test by 7 wickets in 2007.
To be honest, when any team gets beaten, they generally, you know, come back stronger and have more fire in their belly. But what all we can do is concentrate on our game. And
while the English can just focus on their cricket, Team India need to figure out their playing 11, put the psychological damage done aside, and hope the replacement players step up to the plate big time.
First of all, if you're looking for me to replace a person like Sehwag, I think he's one of the greatest opening batsmen from the Indian team. So I think it's going to be big boots to fill, but what I want to do is play my own game.
Abhinav Mukund is someone who will have to put up a better show. He scored just 61 runs in the Lord's Test, but did show lots of promise. After all, it's not easy to fill Sehwag's shoes.
From London, the Indian team has now arrived in Robin Hood country. And if Mahendra Singh Dhoni and his merry men want to steal the momentum from England, then they'll have to bat like princes here at Nottingham. With Jaideep Bhandarkar at the Trent Bridge ground, Nikhil Nas for NDTV.
Well, from cricket over to the 2012 Olympics, and the one-year countdown has more than just the general public excited. British television and film stars are also queuing up to get their tickets, except there are none available.
My mum, for some reason, has decided that her catchphrase now is anything goes wrong in London or in England, she's like, well, the Olympics are sorted out. Like, she thinks, like, the economy, the housing.
I am excited about them coming to London. I haven't applied for tickets, which probably means that I'll be watching them on television.
Well, I applied for tickets for pretty much every event, and I think I might have got the first round of the Tiddlywinks.
Yeah, but I'll watch it on television a long way away from London, because all the roads are going to be closed for VIPs and all that stuff.
I'll be excited if it looks like I'm going to get to see any. Otherwise, I'll be resentful and picketing.
Are we ready? We're bound not to be ready. I'm sure we're not ready.
Actually, you know, I applied for the tennis at Wimbledon, because Wimbledon tickets are a fortune, but Olympic tennis at Wimbledon was only 70 quid, which I thought was a bargain.
It's going to be an amazing year for London, and I'll see any of it if I can. I have no tickets. I think it's impossible to get them now, but it's going to be a great year.
Well, with that, we end this bulletin. Thanks so much for watching, and good night.